Hey, happy holidays to you and yours. Of course, all of this month, we've been showing you recipes from our family, including the New Hampshire Chronicle segment just about a week ago. And with me today is my 3.5-year-old Levi, and he's going to help me make something that our family makes, deviled eggs. Who makes deviled eggs in our family?
Tommy.
Hmm?
Tommy.
You know who makes deviled eggs in our family?
Who?
Papa?
Oh.
Yes. This is going to be an interesting segment, folks. Deviled eggs, it's a fairly universal thing that happens in a lot of families. There isn't an amazing twist to this, but there's a lot of different things you can do with it. We have Levi here mashing up some yolks for me. Let's show you how we get to this point. You take some hard-boiled eggs. Everyone knows how to boil a hard-boiled egg. You cut them in half, and then
Daddy?
You take the yolks, yes, Levi, and you put them into the bowl, just like this. And so you take those deviled eggs, and you let the 3.5-year-old take out some nervous energy and start mashing them. Feel free to go through with that, Levi. From there, there are four things you actually add to this mixture. You take a teaspoon of onion powder and put it in there. And keep mashing, Levi. We'll keep going from here.
Okay.
Yeah, keep going. 3.5-year-olds like to mash. We'll do that right here. Keep going right there. You also take a half teaspoon of hot sauce. It could be any sort of a hot sauce. It could be Tabasco or anything else, and you throw that in there. And as you like to say,
yummo.
Yep, yummo, and a little spicy. Also, we take 2 tablespoons of, what do you call this?
Mustache.
Mustache, yes, it is mustard. You can use any different kind, and it depends on how spicy you like it. You can take this and make a very just normal mustard without much of a spice to it, or you can dump that in there for me. There we go. One more. And you like mustard, don't you? Yes? Yes. Or mustache. And then if you want to, take a little bit of paprika and throw it in there as well. You're going to add a little more paprika,
Daddy.
Later. Yes, honey?
Paprika.
Paprika? It is a spice. It is the red thing that goes on the top of the deviled eggs. So what we're going to do from here is you take this and you mash it together. Now, you can leave a couple of clumps in here if you want. It's kind of like people eating oatmeal where they sometimes like lumps in it, sometimes they don't. And then after you get it to the consistency you want, and you can also put it in a mixer and or a food processor and really get it down to a liquid version if you want. Again, it's all down to personal preference. You take the egg whites that you've cut in half. And there's a couple of ways in which you can do this. You can either scoop it in with a spoon,
Daddy,
as normal.
Daddy.
Yes, Levi.
Come
just like that.
Daddy, look at me.
That is a handle. There we go. And then this is where the extra paprika comes in, where you can just dash a couple of extra little parts of paprika,
Daddy,
onto
Daddy,
it.
Can you move me over here?
Sure. And then I'm going to have you try the deviled egg. Can you do that for me? Give it a little quick little bite? You want the egg white. Okay. To each their own, I guess. So there it is. There's a look at the deviled eggs. It's a wonderful family recipe from Levi, myself, our whole family. A big happy holidays to you and yours. And yeah, cooking in the family, fantastic. It's a great time of year. Have a great day, everybody.